So hello everyone, I'm Mohambusev Chukwukablago, and today this video is the second video for today, and it's going to be about the billion paying your $10 fee, okay, which is very important in if you want to take advantage of, you know, TBC to the fullest, okay. And the $10 fee takes care of your Kringle Cash account, and at the same time takes care of your wallet, giving you lifetime access to your wallet, okay. Now there has been some new development, okay, which is one thing I love about TBC, because constantly there is development, you know, always trying to improve things, we're always trying to get better, and that is what I keep telling people. Whenever they get half doubt about TBC, I tell them, look at the progress we are making. Okay, look at the progress we are making in terms of development and depth of improvement. Okay, so in this case now, I want to head straight to where you pay your $10 fee. Okay, all right. So when you get to your menu, the first thing, when you go down to your account, now some people, if you're new, your menu might not be like this. Okay, you might just have your profile and your account, so make sure you fill out your profile, everything to the detail, okay. Then to your account, your account is what lets you know where you are in terms of your account is what lets you know your status, okay, or your status with TBC. You know, if you've paid a $10 fee, that is where it's going to show up. You know, the status is going to show up. Also, that is where you can also make your $10 payment. All right. Now, I advise people to go through Kringle Cash, because Kringle Cash gives you the option of submitting your transaction details online, the transaction details of your payment on, like, paying directly on the wallet. And at the same time, it's also a plus to have the billion to have access to Kringle Cash, because it helps you in your marketing. Okay, using your referral link on Kringle Cash, it helps you with, you know, cookie reward. Okay, and not only that, it helps you, you know, with attending the same button meeting and getting certain updates with, you know, like when something like migration comes up. Okay, so that is why Kringle Cash is very important. That is why it's best to make your payment through Kringle Cash. Okay, all right, so this is currently slow, but just have to wait it out. So some of the improvements that have been made includes how do I say this? Some of the payments that have been made, that some of the improvements that have been made includes you know, making it easy for you to be able to copy, you know, copy out the address, or making it easy for you to copy the amount you want to pay. Another thing that's been made easy is, you know, increase in the speed of updating your payment status. Okay, so instantly, the moment you click on the click button to copy the address, the system is already waiting for a transaction to be done without your address. So once it recognizes a transaction done to that address that was given to you, it updates your payment. Now, if within an hour it doesn't happen, what you do is simply submit the transaction details. Okay, so as you can see, my status is paid. So this is where you know that your payment has been accepted fully by TBC. Now, there are also cases of you making payment and paying lower fee that will delay, you know, the fast confirmation of your payment, but there are ways around it. And most importantly, there are other options for you to make payment. There is payment with Ethereum, there's payment with Litecoin, but I recommend everybody should pay with Bitcoin. So let's click on make payment with Bitcoin. Okay, now as you can see, previously there is no copy to clipboard. I've mentioned this before. Okay, so you can easily click on it and copy the wallet address instead of trying to highlight everything. You can also copy on this, so this reduces the number of error you're going to experience in terms of paying to the right address, in terms of paying the right amount. Also, this is a new development because this wasn't here before. Let me highlight it. Okay, all right, this wasn't here before. So This is what he says. He says, our payment tracking system will begin looking for your payment when you copy the payment address to your clipboard to begin payment. However, if your payment does not show paid in less than 1 hour, please click here for faster crediting of your payment. Complete this form with your transaction details. Okay? That is this area. Now, well, me personally, I don't wait for an hour. When I help people make their payment, I don't wait for an hour. Immediately I do the transaction, I click on this area and head straight over there to submit the transaction details. Here is why. There was a time the Bitcoin network was congested and a lot of payments were, because of the block size, a lot of payments were under one transaction ID. So you found out that by the time you waste time to go and submit it, somebody would have gone ahead and submitted it because your payment, your $10 fees fall under the same transaction ID under blockchain, okay? Under Bitcoin blockchain, okay? So that's why the moment you make the payment, go straight, click straight here, okay? Clicks, you know, on this blue portion, and it will take you to where you submit the transaction details. Now, what is involved in the transaction details, okay? The transaction details involve, number one, the wallet address that was assigned to you to make payment. That's number one. Number two, the transaction ID or hash ID, okay, of the payment. That is where you were. That is the link. It's a very long link that will be given to you. So that link is where, if you type it in on blockchain, it shows you the block. Okay, the block of where the transaction was done, and shows you whether it's complete or not. Okay, then lastly is the amount in Bitcoin that you paid, which is very, very important, because any error or any waste of time will cause a change in that amount. So you have to be, you know, immediately you are clicking on make payment with Bitcoin, whatever amount you see there, copy it, make payment immediately, and submit the transaction details, okay? So that's it. Now you can read all these things here, but let me make it simple for you, okay? All right, so this is a new thing that is here, okay? Okay, this is a new information that was updated here. It wasn't here before. Okay, it said, note, we use blockchain.info to verify payments. It's recommended to use a blockchain.info wallet or a standalone wallet. If you are using an exchange wallet, your payment may be delayed due to that service. We make every effort to update your payment details as soon as we register payment at blockchain.info. You can search your payment status there. We'll update your paid status within 15 minutes of confirmation. Okay, so blockchain.info is just like the general place where every single transaction that is done on the Bitcoin network is showcasing. Okay, so if you type the wallet address, the Bitcoin wallet address that is paid to, or if you type the transaction ID, it will show you the details of the transaction, whether it has confirmed, how many confirmations it has made, the number of transactions within that block size that is done. Okay. But let me not complicate the issue for you, okay? Where you need to pay attention is here. Now, this is the latest development, okay? Before, it wasn't like this. Before, you had the option to put the amount, the address. You have to, you know, like type in the address you paid to, the transaction ID, then the amount. But in this case now, it's now simple and made easy for you. So the number of errors that used to happen before will be reduced if you pay attention and if you read information. Okay? Now, right now, if you have paid a $10 fee, so what you need to do is come to that, follow the instructions that I've given you previously in this video. When you come here, all you have to do is select address and type. Now, what you can see here, you can see Bitcoin address that was assigned to you to pay to, Litecoin address in case you want to use Litecoin, and Ethereum address in case you want to use Ethereum. Okay, now you select Bitcoin address because that's what you paid to. Okay, now instead of putting amount, now what you are putting is selecting is, you know, What you're selecting now is whether you are paying for 1 month or whether you are paying for a year. Okay? Now, in this case, you select a year, because when you choose 1 month, what it means is that you paid $1, and that $1 does not cover you, you're on your wallet aspect. Okay? But when you pay the 1 year, the year fee, the first $10 you ever paying, okay, and it's $10 for 1 year, okay, it's covering your wallet as well for a lifetime. Okay, now that you've done that, what you need to now do is type in the wallet sent from. Okay, what this means is this: some of you are using Binance, some of you are using blockchain.info, some of you are using different wallets, some of you are using Coinbase, some of you are using Coin Payment, some of you are using Bitcoin. Okay, so what you do is you type in the type of wallet you use. If the wallet is on an exchange, you type in the name of the exchange. If it's a standalone wallet, you type in the name of the standalone wallet. Okay, it's simple. Okay, if you use blockchain.info, type in blockchain.info. If you use Bitcoin, type in Bitcoin. If you use Coin Payments, type in Coin Payments. If you use Luno, type in Luno. If you use Coinbase, type in Coinbase. Okay. All right, so after you've done that, you now put the transaction ID. As you can see the example of the transaction ID. It's a very long ID made up of numbers and alphabets, okay? So you type it in here. Then additional details should include something like date. Okay, I normally put date there for the reason that Fiji time is 11 hours ahead of West African time. Okay, so when I type in the date I made the payment, I put it West African time. So whenever they are looking at the pool of payment that come in, or to confirm the payment that I made, they will look at it based on West African time, not on Fiji time. Okay, all right. Then you now click send. When you click send and it's submitted, it will write on top of here that your transaction details have been submitted. Okay, so that is the recent development on this. It wasn't like this before, but this now makes it simpler and reduces the margin of error. Now you have to also read these tiny instructions under these places that you are asked to, you know, indicate or type in something or select, because if you don't read them and you're ignorant about them, you are most likely to make mistake. Okay, but I have a solution for you if you don't want to make a mistake at all. All you can do is contact me either by call, WhatsApp, or text message, okay, and notify me that you want to make a $10 payment but you don't want to make mistake. Okay, what I'll simply do is help you make the payment. Okay, help you make the payment on your behalf so that you don't experience any errors. And I'll also follow it up by submitting these transaction details for you to ensure that you have zero error when it comes to your payment. Okay? All right. So, and it doesn't cost much for me to help you to do that, but you have to at least, you know, make sure that you're committed not to make mistakes. Okay, if you're certain that you can do it by yourself, fine, no problem, go ahead and do it by yourself. I also sell Bitcoin, I can sell to you. But if you want me to help you, okay, if you want me to help you, I will make sure that your payment status is updated on time, okay, by submitting the transaction details. All right, so guys, that's it for this video. If you have any questions, please send an email or text me or call or WhatsApp. Okay, so to your winning star, my humble self, take care, bye for now.